The day has come, it's time to wire this thing up. Let's just get started. This is gonna be a lot of work. By the title of the video, I'm sure you guys already know what system I went with. It is the Holley Terminator X, not the X Max. I don't need the Max. I have a T56, no nitrous, no turbo, no supercharger. So let me unbox it. And beforehand, I got some additional items. I got the combination alternator and E85 harness. So that should make wiring a little easier and nicer. That way I can run E85 at some point. Oh boy, that's a lot of wires. But such a good looking harness. Ejector harness. What is this? Relay for something? I don't know. This is, I don't even know. That's the screen. That's easy enough. Don't know. This probably goes to. And then in here. Ta-da-da-da. The Terminator X itself. I really have no idea what I'm doing when it comes to this. I'm just gonna wing it like pretty much everything else that I do. I'm gonna look through the instructions real quick and then I'll get to just plugging things in and just see how it goes. So I'm here just unwrapping everything, and obviously there's a whole bunch of stuff to unwrap because there's just wires on wires on wires. And in the rears where everything is super, super tight and hard to get to, you have so many wires back there. You have the vacuum for the brake booster, you've got the coolant hoses, you've got all that. So here I'm just routing like the injector wires and where the coil harness wire is eventually going to go on either side. And then I'm just trying to figure out where everything else should go. There's not that much to this actually. And obviously it all has to run back into the cubby here. So all of these wires kind of just route back here nicely to the passenger side of the engine bay. Thankfully that works out really, really well for an E36. All right, progress, guys. Let me show you where we're at. I have most of the harness connected. Little did I know, and this is my own fault, I didn't realize that it didn't come with the harness for the coil pack, so I gotta order that also. Another thing I forgot, and I assumed I would have forgotten things as we move along, I didn't get a coolant temp sensor. Down in there, you can see there's nothing down there. So I do have all the injectors plugged in. I have the extra harness that I bought, this little guy, for the alternator. That's run down in there. So up front, all I have left is the coolant temp sensor and manifold air temp, which I don't have. And then this whole mess. I got coolant. I finished up the coolant hoses down there. Those are all completely done and bolted in. I have the vacuum line for the brake booster. That's hooked up. All the three sensors back there, that's hooked up. And over here, injectors are hooked up. Now I'm going to work on, I think, mounting. So my thought is, I want to keep it in the factory location because you have this nice cubby here for a reason. So I'm basically going to mount it like that because it won't fit the other way because of this bracket. Unless I cut that out, we'll see. I might cut that bracket out anyway so I can take all of this extra harness, because this is all extra, all of this, and coil it nicely and wrap it up in there so you don't see it. That's the goal. Well, that was a freaking pain. But at least it's out of there now. Now, check out all the room in there. So I should be able to get my ECU in there as well as all of the excess wiring with no problems for a nice clean install. I wasn't sure if I was gonna run this piece. Well, looking at it, I think it'll fit, and I think it'll tidy it all up and make it look pretty nice. Oh yeah, that'll definitely fit. I can fit a bunch of those wires inside here, make it look factory. Preliminary thoughts, yes. Now I'm not convinced I can fit all the wires I have in there. But I might be able to. Yeah, I'm gonna be able to get that to work. Wasn't sure if I could make it work, but I think I can. And it just really cleans up a lot of that wiring. So It's all nice, tucked away in there. Sweet.
All right, that's it for the night. Pick it back up in the morning. Now that everything's in position, there's still a ton more wiring to do, which would be the wiring for the fan output, the wiring to actually power the ECU. And I'm inside the car now in the glove box because I had to drill some holes into the factory ECU location to run the power and ground all the way back to the battery. And I also ended up running the fuse, the fuel pump relay wire back there as well, because it runs right along and then it connects to the fuel pump relay I had already installed for my aftermarket fuel pump. And with everything as it sits, I was able to fit everything in that little cubby, and it cleans up really well, and it's going to look really nice when it's done. Everything's nice and hidden. Now, inside the car here, I am running the power ground and fuel pump trigger wire. Pretty easy to do. End up running along the seat there and then up, and then there is a nice factory grommet on the passenger side up high near the parcel shelf. It's there for some reason. There were no wires in it, but I was able to run it up through there, through the trunk, and then down to eventually the battery and the fuel pump relay that I have. Once I'm back here, just a couple wires that I need to strip, butt connect together, heat shrink, all that. You can see my aftermarket fuel pump relay there I have mounted on the side. That gets hooked up. Pretty simple and straightforward. I think it ended up pretty clean, which is what I wanted. Gentlemen, it may not look like it, but this thing is pretty much ready for its first test fire. Let me go over some of the things that you'll see here that look like a total mess, and right now it is a total mess.
So I just finished up wiring the fan relay. This is ground activated through the Holley, so this is gonna be tucked in there, but for now, it's gonna chill right here with its circuit breaker. I got my coil pack harness, so those are all mounted in. Granted, just keep in mind all this wiring is going to be fully heat shrunk like this isn't right now, and tucked away very nicely in an OEM like setting,
but I need to test fire it first to make sure everything works.
So coming over here, I have the X20 harness. I have it wired up. I have the tack, even though it's going to be off, and then I have the starter wire and the ignition wire for the Holley. And then from the terminal over there is obviously the power to feed the fuse box and the Holley as well.
I also had the starter and alternator all wired up. I went with the harness, like I said earlier, the E85 alternator harness, which is nice because you can't really see it, but that's plugged in like that.
But then down here you can see, now I don't have the zip tied up yet, but it is here. Here's the power wire from the alternator. And that runs down and over and then up to the starter. And then I have the starter wire hooked up as well. There I have the ground wire, the main engine ground. That's hooked up to the factory BMW location. Obviously the power for the power distribution block, the fuse panel over there. Starter and alternator wire down here. So that takes care of everything up front. Now as we move in the car, here are some of the leads. I have a ground that I needed from the Holley. Not the main ground, this is just one of the extra grounds. Here's the main ground that runs to the battery, the main power that runs to the battery, and this is the wire that kicks on the fuel pump. And I also have the Holley dash guy run through here as well. That's just a couple holes there behind the glove box airbag area. Now, those wires are running down here, all along and back up here through that little grommet there that was already there from the factory. And that runs back here. So really, I just need to hook up the battery. Now, I got a brand new battery, and I'll probably make another video about this because it's going to be somewhat custom. Here it is. I wanted to go with something that was lighter weight. So we have it fully charged up here. It's the Odyssey Extreme PC 925. This is the L, positive on the left. So I got a custom mount for this too. So this is a much lighter battery than the factory one, which is this huge freaking thing. This thing's like 50 pounds. So that other battery is about half the weight. I'm gonna mount that in another video. For now, I'm just gonna use it to actually test fire the car. So yeah, I'm gonna hook this up, not mount it, just hook it up, and we'll see what works and if something catches on fire and what happens, who knows. Also guys, I did install the E85 sensor. I wasn't gonna do it till a little bit later, but I decided, hey, I might as well just get it done. That way all that wiring's finished as well. And those wires run down there along with the O2 sensor. And then if you look, you can see it right there. There is the sensor and the wiring itself. Pretty happy with that. Now, with that being said, guys, that is the end of this video. It's getting pretty long. Next video will be first start, or first attempt at first start. So wish me luck. I'm actually going to try it now. I have a good feeling. I have a good feeling. We'll see, though. It's been a long time coming, and I'm really excited, if you can't already tell. So, as always, guys, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.